For the best liberty-oriented talk 24/7, visit LRN.fm.
That was basically it.
They're containing it. All they did was stand here.
No Keene State College, no riot. More thoughts on the disturbance you were indirectly forced to underwrite. First, I wanted to address the most insane and bizarre piece of slander to come out of this crisis. Now, those of you who watch my channel know that I don't hesitate to criticize Ian Freeman and Free Keene. It may be the third most common thing I've done, despite the fact that they're advertisers on my show. But the idea that Free Keene or Ian Freeman supported or abetted these riots is probably the least true thing I've ever heard. For a thing to be so untrue, it has to be the opposite of what actually happened. And what actually happened was Ian Freeman was practically the only person I know of who was doing anything to try and deter the riots or stop them. The police claimed to be, I shouldn't say that. He wasn't the only person trying to stop the riots, but the one that he was filming, he's the only person that I know who was in that area doing anything about it at the time, and he was documenting what the bad guys were doing so that the public, including the police, could retaliate against the bad guys. He did this at some risk to himself, while the police were, maybe they were arguably sort of doing something in the sense that they claimed they were containing that section of the riot. They weren't actually moving in and arresting people while Ian Freeman was filming them, doing this bottle throw. Freeman says they were off tagging some victimless criminals at this point, in some cases. But, I mean, the most infuriating, inappropriate thing that you can say is to take the one... It's like the movie A Man for All Seasons. There's this scene where Thomas More is the only judge, I guess, judge-ish type person of his category who doesn't take bribes. So what do they charge him with? Or they tried to charge him with initially. Taking bribes. Why? Because he's the only one who doesn't. And it's the same way with how Ian got treated here. People who probably did absolutely nothing to stop the rioters or interfere with their happy escape cravenly turned to the one person I know of who was actually doing something constructive, taking action against the bad guys, and that's who they accuse of being the source of the problem. That's the kind of Resident Evil you're dealing with in Keene. Ian actually took his video later and turned all of his raw tape over to police so that they could make arrests, hopefully at less taxpayer expense than would otherwise be the case. Arrests of actual perpetrators. All of these things he's done at some personal risk. No good deed goes unpunished. That town has no idea, some of its residents, how lucky they are to have Free Keene, which, yes, it may be annoying as an activist group, but it's also become an independent and heavily watched media outlet that is not under the control or influence of the authorities. You can't say that about most places in the world. The union leader... Well, I don't know about the union leader, but WMUR and WKBK, as much as I like KBK in particular, those are institutions that can have the government can pull the plug on them anytime it feels like. They are government licensed, and it shows. Some newspapers are a little more independent, but oftentimes that doesn't show. Especially in Keene, where last I heard, the Sentinel was owned by, I guess, one of the ex-mayor's wives, or run by that person, or something along those lines. In any case, way too close to the authorities. And it shows.
LRN.FM, 24 hours of Liberty Radio every day. Now available on satellite, too, at sat.lrn.fm. That's what a satellite sounds like. Put it on your unlicensed station. Wear it in your hair. But above all, don't despair. The Liberty message is getting out. And right now, you're missing it. Or maybe you're not. But skip on over to
lrn.fm. Feds don't want you to hear them.